been an update on Matt Wieters. A lot of fans are wondering about what the status is on Matt Wieters.
Well, you know, Tom, he kind of joked around that he's been avoiding us basically until today. He's been here in Tampa Bay watching the games from the dugout, kind of providing a little bit of a lift for the team and also for him during this tough rehab process. Now, Matt Wieters is on an every other day catching schedule, which means that he hasn't been able to recover well enough after catching, say, 5 innings in extended spring. He's had to take that next day off. He acknowledged he's still dealing with a little bit of elbow soreness. The Orioles won't obviously send him out on rehab assignment until he's able to go back-to-back games and feel okay. Now, reminder to everybody wondering why this is taking so long, June is still that one-year mark for catcher Matt Wieters. So when we asked him what it felt like when he first caught that game in spring training on March 17th, he said it felt like months ago. And really, it was. And I think what they're trying to do now is be safe and be smart. He pushed it and pushed it and pushed it, trying to be ready to start the season. It didn't work. Now they're going slow. They're being patient. They're not in really a real rush here. Caleb Joseph has been catching very well. Offensively, he's given them what they need. Defensively, more than they could have expected out of him, particularly since they weren't so sure last year what they were going to get. So with Matt Wieters, they're going to give him all the time he needs to recover.
Britt, how about J.J. Hardy and Ryan Flaherty? Both have missed some valuable playing time this season.
Yeah, real good news for them, Tom. Both of them are going to, after today's game, head to Double-A Bowie. They're going to start that rehab assignment. Definitely play Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. I'm not so sure about that 11 a.m. game. Orioles manager Buck Showalter joked that maybe they won't be ready for that game. It's so early in the morning. Both those guys could take that as a rest day, but they hope they take it as a travel day and that they meet the team in New York after that. Ryan Flaherty, of course, eligible to come off the DL on Friday. Barring any setbacks, he should be ready. J.J. Hardy, however, hasn't played at all this season. He might need a little bit more time. They're doing their best to combat that. Hardy was out here earlier. Guys were throwing side sessions. Hardy was tracking, just trying to do everything he can to make up for not playing in games, not seeing major league pitching for the first month plus of the season.
Now, Britt, the Orioles have played only 3 games so far this week. How has it affected the rotation and the rest of the pitching staff?
It's been really interesting. You know, certain guys respond really well to rest. Certain guys you got to rein in a little bit. Now, I spoke with pitching coach Dave Wallace this morning, and he said that every member of the pitching staff had an extra bullpen to carry over to kind of make sure that they were still in sync mechanically, mentally, while they had at least 2, some of them 3 extra days in between their start. It doesn't get any easier for them. They have an off day again tomorrow. So keeping these guys on schedule has been really tough. They've got the chart out of guys, how they perform on certain days of rest, which guys might need to throw twice even extra given all of this extra rest. But it's been a little bit of a challenge. Miguel Gonzalez said that he was a little jumpy yesterday, had an extra fastball, and even the relievers. You know, Brad Brock was throwing 97 last night. Caleb Joseph said he had to kind of slow him down a little bit. These guys are so excited. They've got extra zip. Their arms feel great. The challenge, of course, is mechanically. And Dave Wallace said that's something they've stressed to these guys. Look, you're going to feel good. You're going to feel like you're throwing 200 miles an hour, but you've got to be able to locate it and command it. And that's what this rotation has done particularly well, even given that long layoff.
Well, Brittany, as always, we appreciate your inside look at the Orioles. Look forward to talking to you in the not too distant future. Brittany Giroli covers Major League Baseball and the Orioles for MLB.